Blanca Gonzalez.
Mona Lenardi. Mona was one of my recommendations for today, so I wanted to make sure that I introduced all of you to her. Mona Lenardi lost her son Michael to an accidental fentanyl poisoning on February 24th, 2020. Michael was 20 years old and in his first year of college when fentanyl, hidden in a single pill that Michael believed to be Percocet, took his life. Her grief over the senseless loss of her son lit a fire in her to spread awareness of the dangers of fentanyl and illicit pills. She founded the Michael Lenardi Foundation to raise awareness around fentanyl poisoning and educate the community on the current public health crisis in memory of her son Michael, noting that he lived his life with an open heart and believed in the power of knowledge and the importance of social justice. I attended Michael's memorial, and that boy was magic. Mona.
Linda Hamlin is a volunteer at the district attorney's office, so she will be working with me soon. She was nominated to be honored today for her dedication and commitment to assisting victims in recovering restitution. Linda previously worked at our office from 2004 to 2019 as a restitution specialist, but her passion for victim advocacy has led her to returning to our office as a valuable volunteer. After her retirement, her wealth of knowledge is invaluable to our office and most importantly to the victims. Linda Hamlin is a hero in our community. Thank you, Linda.
Very quickly about Linda, I can't overemphasize the need for survivors to get their money back. It's an often forgotten part of the criminal justice system. People don't kind of think about that. To me, restitution collection is so boring, and it's so much paperwork, and I have never, Linda has collected that money, gotten it back into the hands of survivors and their families, and it is so critically important to them, and we're so grateful that you're here today, and that you continue to volunteer with us after you retired. It's a gift. Thank you so much. Roxana Plancarte. Plancarte? I think I mispronounced that. Roxana led the news a Spanish support group for many years, which had full attendance every week. Clients would in fact refer to News' support group by calling it Roxana's group. It was the love, care, and support that she offered that made this group so successful. Now that Roxana has moved on to become the St. Helena Unified School District social worker, she continues to regularly refer families to News. Our community is so fortunate to have Roxana, and we are sure that she is contributing to violence prevention in our community up in St. Helena. Thank you, Roxana.
Next is Officer Anna Paulson. CHP Officer Anna Paulson was nominated to be honored today for her investigative work in a double vehicular homicide. Anna went above and beyond with the victims and their family members. One of the victims lived for 4 days after the incident, and Anna checked in with the hospital daily to see how she was, because she genuinely cared. Anna came to court for many court appearances and attended the sentencing because this case mattered to her. Anna's work on this case didn't end when she submitted her report. She was invested and she made sure to show support to everyone involved. In the few days that I've been in this job, I've already heard many times about how wonderful she is. Officer Anna Paulson.